U.S. Commerce Chief Ross kept holdings in Russian tide firm reports. Washington, Reuters, U.S. Commerce Secretary Wilbur Ross has kept investments in a shipping firm with significant business ties to Russian President Vladimir Putin's inner circle, U.S. media reported on Sunday, citing leaked documents from an offshore law firm. Partnerships used by Ross, a billionaire investor helping to shape President Donald Trump's trade policy, have a 31% stake in Navigator Holdings, which the New York Times said earns millions of dollars a year transporting gas for Russian petrochemical firm Sibur. Gennady Timchenko, a Russian oligarch and Putin of Soch's associate subject to U.S. sanctions, and Putin's son-in-law, Kirill Shamilov, are Sibur stakeholders, said the Times, which based its report on files from Appleby, a prominent offshore law firm. Reuters was unable to independently confirm the findings. In an emailed statement, a Department of Commerce spokesman said Ross was not involved in Navigator's decision to engage in business with Sibur, has never met the Sibur shareholders referenced in this story, and, until now, did not know of their relationship. He added that Sibur had not been under sanctions when Navigator began its relationship with the publicly traded firm and still was not. According to the Times, Sibur said in a statement that any negotiations with Navigator over the years were carried out by its executives, not its major shareholders, and that no meetings were held with Mr. Ross. Neither Navigator nor Appleby were immediately available for comments Sunday evening. Reuters could not immediately reach Timchenko and Shamilov for comment. The Appleby files are part of the so-called Paradise Papers, a trove of leaked offshore investment documents. They were obtained by Germany's Süddeutsche Zeitung newspaper and shared with the International Consortium of Investigative Journalists, ICIJ, and some media outlets. The ICIJ published the Panama Papers last year, leaked documents from Panama law firm Mossack Fonseca that chronicled the shadowy world of offshore holdings and hidden wealth. Scrutiny of Trump administration officials' possible ties to Russia has intensified as a result of probes into alleged Russian interference in the 2016 U.S. election. In its report, The Times said Ross had kept the investment in Navigator, which increased its business dealings with Sibur even as Western nations sought to punish Russia's energy sector over Putin's incursions into Ukraine. Navigator was mentioned in Ross's 57-page public financial disclosure report filed in December, before he officially joined the Trump administration. The Times said the latest batch of documents provided more insight into his financial holdings. The secretary recuses himself from matters focused on transoceanic shipping vessels, the Commerce Department spokesman statement said, adding that Ross works closely with officials to ensure the highest ethical standards. Queen's taxes citing the Appleby documents, Britain's Guardian newspaper said millions of pounds from Queen Elizabeth's private estate, the Duchy of Lancaster, had been invested in a Cayman Islands fund as part of an offshore portfolio never before disclosed. Reuters could not independently confirm the Guardian report. The newspaper said the duchy had used offshore private equity funds designed to shield investors in the United Kingdom from having to pay U.S. tax on their holdings. A spokesman for Buckingham Palace declined to comment. A spokeswoman for the Duchy of Lancaster said, "We operate a number of investments, and a few of these are with overseas funds. All of our investments are fully audited and legitimate." The spokeswoman also said the Queen voluntarily pays tax on any income received from the duchy. Citing the documents, Guardian also reported that international trading firm Glencore had secretly loaned tens of millions of dollars to Israeli businessman Dan Jordler after enlisting him to secure a mining deal in the Democratic Republic of Congo. The British newspaper said Jordler had denied any wrongdoing. Reuters was not immediately able to contact him. Glencore said in a statement sent to Reuters on Sunday, but dated October 27 and addressed to the ICIJ, that it had made a loan to a company affiliated to Jertler in 2009 on commercial terms, and that it was fully repaid. In February 2009, Glencore Finance, Bermuda, Limited made a loan to Laura Enterprises Limited, Laura, an entity affiliated with Mr. Jertler, the company said. The loan to Laura, was made on commercial terms negotiated at arm's length, it said. The loan was fully repaid by Laura in 2010. Reporting by Susan Cornwell. Additional reporting by Barbara.